Good morning, everybody. We are going ice fishing today. Oh, she looks thick enough. We'll be all right. We're at a pond that I have been to before, but not ice fishing. I think I came here one time, open water fishing. I think it was during the summer, and I caught a couple 4 or 5 pound bass. And I'm with Sam Ripping Lips. Him and I went hunting, you know, a couple months ago at Webfoot Farms. And so we're here on this nice little pond. You guys can see it's not a giant body of water, but supposedly it's got some big fish. So we're gonna give it a shot. We're doing something different though. We are using a mystery tackle box. Yes, they have an ice fishing edition. We're using the mystery tackle box today to see if we can catch fish with some of the baits that they sent. So therefore, this video is sponsored by Mystery Tackle Box. So huge thanks to those guys for making my videos possible and hopefully allowing us to catch some fish today. I don't know if you guys could tell, but I am sick. I think I am coming down with the flu. I spent 3 days hunting in Kansas. Super cold weather, laying in a field, and came home and feel absolutely awful right now. But you know, I gotta make videos for you guys. That's what it's all about. So I gotta suck it up, you know, even though it's a little bit chilly out here today. Suck it up, whether I have the flu or not. I don't know, I guess I'll find out after I go to the doctor. But for right now, the objective is to catch a bunch of fish. Big bluegills, big bass, big crappie. And if this pond doesn't work, there's a lake right down yonder that we're actually gonna give a shot. But I'm gonna shut up, let's get started. Well, folks, here we are, drilled a few holes. We're gonna get some tip-up set out here in a minute, but as I said before, video is sponsored by Mystery Tackle Box, so huge shout-out for those guys. If you wanna try out your own Mystery Tackle Box, make sure you use promo code FLAIR. You get $10 off your very first box. I will link it down below if you wanna check it out, but I'm gonna open this guy. A lot of you guys probably have not seen the ice fishing box. I believe this is the first time I've actually ever used the ice fishing box from Mystery Tackle Box, so I'm gonna show you guys what's inside. We're gonna tie out a couple baits, see if we can jig up some panfish and some bass, and see how it goes. So first things first, you get this little guy here. Get a nice little piece of paper, a bunch of great information on it that doesn't work well in a strong wind. So we're just gonna set that down here. But the important stuff here is we got the baits. We got the dot. You guys can see there, just some nice little ice jigs. We got some 13 Fishing Whisker Sour Sneak Donkey Sauce Infused little jigs. They basically look like wax worms. So if you don't have wax worms handy, you can use these guys. We got a knuckle ball jig Jit R. So it looks like it's got like a little blade on it. Something that looks about like that. Something that for sure you put like a big minnow on, go for some bigger size bass, maybe some walleye, stuff like that. We got a lip ripper's little worm there. Basically looks like a night crawler. So if the fish are keying in on, you know, little night crawlers instead of wax worms, bigger presentation, that guy will work fantastic. Now we got some tungsten ice jigs, which I've actually never even used a tungsten ice jig. So probably gonna try those out today. And then we got the little Dibbles digest action and a little sticker there. So that's what came inside this month's mystery tackle box for the ice fishing edition. We're gonna tie on a couple of these baits, see if we can catch some fish.
Here we go, baby. A little waxy action. And I did tie on that little tungsten jig that I just talked about in the unboxing. You can see just teeny tiny little tungsten jig. I've never used a tungsten jig, so I want to try it out. You know, that's the great thing about mystery tackle boxes. I've been fishing pretty much my entire life. Not as much ice fishing as open water fishing, of course, but I mean, I've never purchased a tungsten jig, so I'm gonna see if it makes a difference. Because I mean, I use tungsten all the time, open water bass fishing, and it does make a difference. We're gonna see if it makes a difference doing a little bit of ice fishing here. Drop this bad boy down there. See if we can make some magic happen. We got a tip up, folks. Oh God, here's the far one. I'm going. Middle school track trained me for this moment. Oh yeah, it's a fish, it's running with it. Yep, see it spinning? Yep, it's got it. Let him take it till it stops. Yep, got it. What is it? Bass. Woo! Yes, son! First fish, baby. Bass. Not a giant, but I'll take it. Come here, buddy. Oh, barely hooked. Right in the corner of the mouth. Look at that beautiful little thing there. Just a guppy, but we'll take it. What do you think?
I like it.
First one of the day, baby, on the old tip up. See you, buddy. Oh, wait, hang on. You guys roasted me in the last video, so let me put him head first. Bye, buddy. Oh, see, look what he did. He flipped around on himself. Okay. Not my fault. Not my fault. Woo! We're sitting here, obviously, by a tree. You guys see the tree? That's a good indication of where to start. You know, especially like today, I'm fishing a pond. I've never ice fished before, so I have no idea, you know, what the hot spots are. But next to a tree, next to cover, next to structure, that's always a go-to for me. Alrighty, folks. I know you guys have probably already seen this, but this is my tip-up rig, homemade tip-up rig. I know I'm gonna make a video, okay? But the guy who makes these, I have to basically go to his house and have him show you, because he's got all the parts to actually show you how to make them. But I'm going to, don't worry. Anyways, this is my homemade tip-up setup. This is what I use in pretty much all my ice fishing videos. My favorite rig, way better than store-bought in my opinion. And yeah, so you got this little depth finder, is what you call it. It's just basically a lead weight and a hook. You drop her on down there, all the way down to the bottom. Not that deep, okay? And you pick up on this till it gets tight, just about like that. I'll pinch right about here. So right now it's slack. Right now it's tight. You bring it up to the top of this thing. That's about 6 to 8 inches. Then you tie this fancy little loop knot like this over. You pinch it tight. Then you bring it up, and that's your loop and your slip knot. So I'm going to make a video about how to do all this. Then you hook a minnow on that, and you drop it down. Then you stick this loop on the top of the hook. So when the fish actually grabs it, this flag gets flipped up like that. And then, you know, that's why it's called a tip up, because it tips the flag up. That's essentially how it is. I'm gonna drop them down there. I usually drop my minnows 6 to 12 inches off the bottom. That's just my go-to, and it's worked every day that I've gone ice fishing. So we're gonna give it a shot, folks. We'll see how it goes. Oh, there's a fish on it. Come on, take it, buddy. Take it. Oh, there's a fish on it. Come on, take it. Oh, there's a couple fish on it. Yep, yep, bite. Come on, take it. Take it, come on, take it, take it, take it. Oh, there's fish all over it, baby. Got him. Oh, he's caught up, woo! First gill, baby. Not a giant, but I'll take him. Got tangled up in the old fish finder. There you go, get off there, son. Now we're talking, baby. Got a little gilly on the tungsten ice jig. Must have just been a bunch of little guys fighting over it, because it's not a very big jig for them to get in their mouth, but I'll take it. See, buddy. Oh, there's another fish. Do you have it? Got him. Another gill. Mystery Tackle Box, move. It's on the move. Mystery Tackle Box is on the move, and I just got another gill, baby. All right, I gotta go save the possessions. Come here, buddy. Don't you go. You come back here. These gills here are absolutely destroying this jig. I finally found some juiciness. It's actually a pretty small guy. I'm halfway tempted to stick this guy on a tip up, but I would like a little bit smaller one. But you guys saw me do that last time and it worked. So we're gonna keep on seeing if we can catch these guys. Hoping for a little bit smaller one. Hook them on a tip up and see if we can catch a giant. There's one. Take it. There we go. See there? He is there. Oh my God. That's the size we need on a tip up. Yeah. I might go exchange him. There's a baby. Minnow, it's your lucky day, buddy. Bluegill guy, not so much. Stick this hook right through ya. Just like that. Looking like a snack. Oh, we got a tip up. Oh no. All right, well, this rod's probably gonna go in the water. Uh-oh. Oh shoot. Yeah, it's going. You got this, Sam. You got this. It's going. There's a fish. All right, let it take it. All right, go ahead and grab it. When you feel him, just give a nice jerk and start pulling straight up. He's on there. Got him?
Yep.
There you go. Yeah! Woo! Dude, nice bass. My rod's literally probably in the water right now. I was getting totally smoked by bluegills when I came over here. They were starting, yeah, they were lighting up that jig. Dude, congrats. Is that your first tip-up fish ever?
Yeah.
Dude, hold that beauty out, son. First tip-up fish ever for you, huh?
Yeah.
It's pretty cool reeling with your hands, isn't it? It's way different.
Bass too.
Way different. All right, what are you naming that guy?
Leonardo.
Leonardo, I like it. See ya, buddy. Oh yeah, beauty. Back in the water, Leonardo goes. All right, well, that was the tip-up. We caught the one earlier. Now this one, we got one over there, and my rod is probably in the water, so I'm gonna go give a check on it and see what's going on. There's a fish down there. Drop on him. Right about there. Do a few jigs, see what happens. Oh yeah, they just come in little wolf packs. Whole bunch of them. These gills have just been moving out and then coming back. There's one. Got him. Little guy, little baby. They just, basically you catch one and then they all kind of disappear. And then you just kind of wait 5 minutes, they all come back and you catch one and they disappear and you do it over and over again. I'm gonna see if I can catch another one. These guys didn't leave. Before I drop that other one down, I'm gonna try to catch another one. One's already on it. Yep, one's already on it. Got him. Got him fired up, boys. Look at that, I'm on a roll. There's a bite. Come on, take it. Got him. What do we got? Oh, he's stuck under the ice. Oh, he came off. It was a crappie. No. That was my first crappie. Crappie came off. He got stuck on the edge of that ice. Came off. That was sick. I ain't caught a crappie all year long. Wasn't a giant, but hell, I'd take him. Got him. Oh, it's a bluegill. Where's your crappie, buddy? That's not terrible. I'll get you out of the way. Put you back. Tell your friends. They need to come bite this little jig. There he goes. Got him. Oh! We doing big things out here, folks. As you can see, we are finessing these little guys. Not giants by any means. This is bass bait. But the bass actually aren't even liking these things today. We've had no luck on them so far. We're not having any luck on the tip-ups with the gills. You know, nothing's liking it. And I'm getting fairly chilly right now, like I said before. I'm pretty sick. really shouldn't be out here. I mean, if my doctor saw me out here, he'd kick my ass. But I'm out here anyway because you guys need some entertaining content. I know what it's like, you know, in the winter time for those of you guys that don't or are not able to go ice fishing or haven't been ice fishing, you know, during the school days or school week when you have school, even though Sam skipped. Hopefully Sam's teachers aren't watching this. And I know I was trying to release some entertaining content for you guys. But anyways, I think we're gonna pretty much call it. We got to go pick up all the tip-ups. Not going to film any of that. That's not really all that interesting. But Sam caught his first bass on a tip-up through the ice, which is crazy. Was that your first ice bass ever?
Yeah.
There you go. First bass ever caught through the ice by that guy and first tip-up fish, which is totally different than, you know, a normal fish. He caught a ton of gills. I got a ton of gills, and then I caught a bass. So it wasn't the exact day I pictured out here. I really did hope we were going to catch a giant bass, but it didn't happen. Not the end of the world, folks. You know, you get out here, you spend a few hours in the afternoon freezing your ass off, catching some fish, and it's always a good time, you know, and you can't ever complain when you're fishing right now. It's better than being in school and or being at work or whatever like that. So can't complain too much. I really do hope you guys enjoyed watching. Remember, if you want to try out Mystery Tackle Box for the very first time, use promo code FLARE. You get $10 off your very first box. I'll leave the link down below. You guys try it out. As you guys saw, they sent some tungsten jigs. We caught a ton of bluegills on them, which is fantastic. They sent a bunch of stuff I didn't even get open. I'm actually going to try to go fishing tomorrow, but inside of an ice hut that's heated so I don't keep getting more sick than I already am. I will take that box out there tomorrow too and see if I can catch some more fish. But for now, maybe a catch and cook, actually. If you guys want to see a catch and cook, drop a like down below. Let me know in the comment section down below. Maybe I'll do a catch and cook. I don't know. Something a little bit different. Anyways, I'm going to quit rambling. Really appreciate you guys tuning in and sticking to the end. If you guys stayed to the end, really do appreciate it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and peace!